Hey, it's Nicoletta here, and today I am going to show you how to make these paper birds. So, as you can see, I've made some prior to the tutorial. So, I've made a smaller one and a bigger one. So, I'm going to do the big one for you just for the sake of easiness. And so, this is what it looks like. So, I'm going to show you the grey one. So here's the grey one. So, this is what it'll look like. That was really cool looking. You actually hang them up if you want to make a mobile island. Just somehow puts red through it, you know, just up in there and just make a wee mobile, you know. So it would look good. But yeah, so this is what you'll need. So a nice square piece of paper, any size, depends how big you want your bird. So what you want to do is you want to fold it up like this. Hope you can see. Just fold it into triangle. Make sure everything's nice and neat and precise. Just like that. Like always, you place everything into place nice and firmly. Just like that. Yeah, what you want to do is just fold it like this. So you just like triangle there, and then you just fold the bottom to the top. Just like this. It's actually very simple once you get the hang of it. Again, make sure it's all even. Like so. So there you'll get a smaller triangle. And what you want to do is, you can see the end here, the opening, so just leave it closed. But what you want to do is grab this end here. Just bring it right up to the top here. So what you're doing is that, so simply bring it up again, be nice and neat, make sure all the lines are nice and even as possible. So you're basically getting that, turn it over and repeat just like this, so you'll get an even smaller triangle. So you will. So there's a wee triangle. So what you'll get is you'll end up with this here shape. So that's what you'll end up with. So what you want to do is you want to grab this here. So this is what you're gonna want to do. You just grab the two layers. So you've got two layers here, that layer and that layer. Grab the two layers here. And just bring the tip right up to the middle here. So press down. So what you'll see is you've got this here. So what I've done, there is a line there, and then you just fold the tip up nice and even to the edge here. And again, repeat on the other side. Again, being nice and careful to make sure it's all neat and tidy. So take your time, like so. So you'll end up with this here. Just press into place. So what you want to do next, now just open up here. So you want to, suppose you're the mountain fold and then down into a valley fold, just like that. So you're basically inverting it, turn it inside out. So yeah, you just want to, can be a wee bit tricky, but shouldn't be too bad. Just making sure it's all even. Oops. Should be okay. Just may want to play about with a wee bit. Just make sure it's all sitting all right. Just so now you have the inverted fold to the mountain fold, or the valley fold, should I say. Now repeat with the other side. Just open this flap up. Just right in there. So yeah, again, you've got two layers of paper to work with. So one layer there and the second set of layers there. So you've got that there, so just Try not to split them up, so just keep them two sides together in their own way as such. So turn it inside out, just in a nutshell as such. And that first time around can be a bit fiddly. Don't know why that side was easier, but anyway. It's funny. So there we are, that's what we end up with, like a roof of a house shape type of thing. So what do you want to do? This is the head and this is the tail end. So you can see the head and the tail end, like so. So what you want to do is with the head, people will actually fold down that way, but you want to turn it upside down and fold like this. So I will try and show you the line. You'll just about feel the line, the crease line, underneath the paper where you've turned your valley fold, your mountain fold inside out, down to your valley fold. You will find your way. So you will end up with that. So basically, that's what I showed you, and you're basically folding the head up like that. Make sure it's creased into place. And right, now another bit. Open this up. This is what you'll get. You can see. Again, turn this around here so that all the folds are facing upwards. And you want to just, again, turn this into a valley fold. Again, I know a little tricky bit today, but you should be able to get it. Just like that. And that's what you'll end up with. So that's the head, the beak. So, starting with the wings. Very easy, you'll be able to just grab each side of the wing and just fold right back, press into place. So that's one wing done. And just grab and fold right back up. So that's what you have, is the wings and the head. Now, the tail is another easy thing. So this is where you want to fold the tail right down, so it goes down along this line here, just like this, nice and neat. Oh, just like that. And another process of turning this inside out, down to a valley fold, mountain fold. It actually looks nice as it is, but you can kind of just, again, it can be tricky, but you'll be able to, just like that. Just like so. And that is your bird. So you can open the wee wings up a wee bit more. You can draw an eye on, but I'm not going to. So yeah, that's your tail and that male, and that's the whole entire bird. So yeah. So a wee family of birds. So yeah, that is how you make your bird. So see ya!